So usually, as we are covered the definitions and the symbolic representations into the mathematical form for this probability theory, we use the variable x or variable y to represent the random variable. So there must be a certain criteria, so because of which we can call a random variable to be of the Gaussian type here. So mathematically, when we are representing a random variable for x, it will be a Gaussian type when its probability density function is expressed into this formula here. As we are already seen, for a random variable x here, there can be a probability distribution function represented as capital F suffix x as a function of alpha, to which when a derivation is carried out, we obtain the probability density function, and here it is the representation. So to the suffixes, there it is a mention of particular random variable for which that density function or distribution function is represented here. So small f suffix x as a function of alpha is the probability density function for the random variable x here, and it is mathematically expressed as, first of all, a ratio or inverse you can call about, because the numerator is nothing but 1 here. So 1 upon we have sigma suffix x in multiplication to square root of 2 pi. So this ratio here we have in multiplication to the exponential form, the exponential form of minus of again a ratio, where the numerator is square of the difference of alpha with m suffix x here, and the denominator is twice of sigma suffix x square here. So in this particular mathematical representation, we come to know that the probability density function f suffix x as a function of alpha is completely dependent on the knowledge of mx here, the sigma suffix x square here, the sigma suffix x here, the constant pi here. So in this particular representation, mx is nothing but the mean of the random variable, mean, either we call mean or expected value, so that is mx, along with sigma suffix x square, that is nothing but the variance. When both of these values are known, so the square root of the variance will lead to the standard deviation sigma suffix x, pi is of course a constant here. So it is completely dependent on the mean and the variance here. Now, as the title of this topic is Gaussian random variables, we have shown you the mathematical representation with the help of this formula. The graphical representation for the Gaussian shape is very simple and popular like this. So this is what the Gaussian shape represented with the help of the two axes. So the vertical axis and the horizontal axis, they are intersecting at the origin, and at that the origin, the value of this function is at maximum, and into the symmetry it is going on to decay on both the sides, positive as well as negative here. So as we have shown you the probability density function, so it is completely dependent on the mean and the variance here. So that was the case for only one random variable. When we increase one more random variable, so let us take the case where we have the two random variables, suppose they are x and y now. So what is the criteria? That time we can call these two variables to be of the Gaussian random variables. So again, we shall take the help of the probability density function. As we have the two random variables, we have to represent the joint Gaussian probability distribution function here. So mathematically, here we represent small f as a function to represent the probability density function, and in the suffix x, y, both the random variables have been mentioned. So it is a function of alpha and beta, alpha for x, beta for y here. So it is expressed in terms of capital A in multiplication to the exponential function. So the exponential function is over, the things are written within the curly bracket here. We have minus of 1 upon twice in the bracket 1 minus rho suffix xy squared here. So rho is the correlation coefficient here. So this ratio is again in multiplication to the square bracket here, that extends up to the three terms here. The first term is the ratio of square of alpha minus mx, mx meaning the same mean of the random variable x, and it is divided by sigma suffix x square, which is the variance of random variable x here, minus the second term involves the multiplication of twice the correlation coefficient rho suffix xy to the ratio of numerator involves the multiplication of the two brackets, the first one alpha minus mx, the second one beta minus my, and this is divided by the multiplication of the two standard deviations sigma suffix x and sigma suffix y here. Lastly, there it is, the third term added to these two, that is beta minus my squared is divided by the variance of random variable y here, sigma suffix y squared here. So in this particular representation, the RHS involves the variance correlation coefficient, the mean here. So along with these, the exponential function that has been over, we have the representation of capital A. So this capital A is nothing but the inverse of, here we have twice pi in multiplication to sigma x into sigma y, and that is multiplied by the square root of the difference of 1 minus rho suffix xy squared here, the square of the correlation coefficient here. So the information already we have discussed, that we have mx and my correspondingly the means, and sigma suffix x square, sigma suffix y square the corresponding variances, or now we call the x and y to be the Gaussian random variables, as we have represented with the help of probability density function. The use of correlation coefficient was also represented, that it was rho suffix xy. And now, as with the single case of random variable that we have first of all seen before this joint density function, we have completed the specified one, the means, variance and correlation to be the known values here. Now there are certain properties so that we can characterize the Gaussian random variables. So we have four properties. Let us go with the first property here. So for the first property, we take the joint case here. If we have x and y to be the jointly Gaussian, so then for the constants a and b, the random variable representation in net form will be like this. So here we have the net random variable of the Gaussian type represented here. So it is z here, and z is in terms of x and y along with the two constants a and b here. So z is equal to ax plus by here. So here it is Gaussian with the mean. So the mean of the net random variable z, which comprises of the two x and y, can be represented as m suffix z here. So m suffix z can be computed if we have the knowledge of individual means for the random variables x and y along with the two constants a and b here. So m suffix z, the mean of random variable z, is equal to a into mx added to b into my here. Now after the knowledge of mean, we should also require to know the variance. The variance is always represented by sigma square, and into the suffix, the representation of the random variable is there. So in the similar fashion to the mean, we have the representation of variance for the random variable z by this expression. So in this expression, we have sigma suffix z squared here, the variance of the random variable z here. So it is expressed into the three terms added with each other. The first one is a square multiplied to the variance of the random variable x. The second term is b square multiplied to the variance of the random variable y, usual case, and this is added to the last term, where we have twice AB in multiplication to the product of standard deviations of random variables x, y here, that is sigma x into sigma y, in multiplication to the correlation coefficient rho suffix x, y here. So this was all with respect to the property 1. Now, if we have to proceed, let us have the property number 2. So in property number 2, we shall again take the joint case. So the joint case of the Gaussian, the random variables, and these are uncorrelated. So the uncorrelatedness can be expressed when we have the correlation coefficient to be equal to 0. So in that particular case, we have the statistically independency of the two joint Gaussian random variables x and y here. So thereupon, the probability density function has the relation as capital, here we have the small for the density, the capital is for the distribution function. So small f suffix xy is the probability density function for the joint random variables xy as a function of alpha comma beta. So this is the product of the multiplication of individual probability density functions of the random variables x and y. So this is nothing but the property 2 for the Gaussian random variables here. Now it's time of the property number 3. So in property number 3, again we take x and y to be the joint random variables of the Gaussian type here. And now the optimum nonlinear estimation, as into the 6th topic we have addressed the linear mean square estimation, thereupon we have represented zeta to be the minimum value of the mean square error. So the mean square error requires the knowledge of estimate of y, so that we can have the difference y minus y cap, which is to be squared, and the expected value or the mean is to be taken to compute the value of that particular mean square error zeta here. So here, for this particular reason, let us have y cap to be g as a function of x. So this minimizes the mean square error. The formulation, we can have substitution of y cap by g of x. So for zeta, we have the representation. So in this representation, here it used to be y cap into the initial case, and from this particular equation we have the substitution of g of x. So if the estimation is a function of the random variable gx, so that time the linear type of estimation that we obtain, and it is represented as y cap equal to, we have ax added to b here. So y cap is equal to ax plus b is nothing but the linear estimation in this particular case. So this is what the property 3 is. Now we shall go for addressing the last property related to the Gaussian random variables. So that is property number 4 here. So here we are going to take, if x is a Gaussian and the mean of this random variable x, if it is 0. So we shall call it to be a 0 mean random variable of Gaussian type. So in that particular case, the mean that we generally represent by the expected value, here we have represented capital E as a function of, in the curly brackets, x to the power n. So when n value to this particular power is even value, so that time this mean opts the value 1 in multiplication to 3, in multiplication to 5. So this way it goes on up to n minus 1 in multiplication to sigma suffix x, and the power is represented by n here. So whatever the selection there, it is of even type. Whereas if we have n to be the odd value, so by default the expected value of the same is equal to 0. So this was all with respect to the Gaussian type of the random variables, very popular into the probability theory.